Howdy guys and gals, I'm Kyle Broderick, welcome to the Social Regressive. We've been testing the Savage Stealth Evolution in 6.5 Creedmoor for a while now. We've done some unknown distance challenges, we've done some long distance precision shooting on clay pigeons, make sure you check out those videos, and then I did put together a full review of the whole rifle, what I think of it, how the various parts work together, and one of the things that I mentioned in that review was a possible incompatibility with different Accuracy International Pattern magazines in this chassis. Everybody's supposed to be kind of using the same standard with this Accuracy International stuff, and it seems like there are some dimensional differences between some of the magazines, and I'm going to try to take a look today and see which things I consider to be compatible, which ones work a little bit better. We're going to take a close look at that, and actually I'm kind of curious about this too. There are some tests that I have not run yet. I have three different magazines going on right here. This is the MDT magazine that came with the chassis. All of these are 10 rounders, and naturally, since this one actually came with the rifle, it runs really great. We also have an Accurate Mag magazine right here. This is steel, it's heavy, very slick. This thing seems to be put together very, very well. And a Magpul P-Mag. And this is the first one that I tested out and found that it didn't really seem to work. A lot of the time it wouldn't pick up the second round. Things just seemed a little bit clunky. We're gonna take another close look at that. The ammunition that we're testing out today, this is Federal Gold Medal Berger. This has a 130 grain bullet, and it definitely comes in just slightly less than magazine length. So this should be a nice standard to test this against instead of some of my hand loads or something like that. And then I also did bring out this Accurate Mag bottom metal, so we can take a look at all three of these mags and see how they fit with this. Now naturally, it's not attached to a rifle, so we can't actually test how feeding works. I'm going to be putting together a rifle in the near future based on the Savage 12 FV, and I will be including this. So you're getting a little bit of a sneak peek if you're watching this video. You can see one of the parts that I'm going to be putting into that Savage 12 FV to make it into a more capable rifle. Let's take a close look at these mags. I've loaded 5 rounds into the MDT magazine. We're going to run this one first, and naturally I have run a whole lot with this, so I'm not really concerned about it. This is not quite as slick feeding as the Magpul P-Mag was in the Accurate Mag bottom metal that we had on the Model 10 GRS. I mentioned that in the Savage Evolution review, but it still works just fine. So let's take a look at this. I have the safety in the kind of halfway position. That's the one that allows us to run the bolt, but it won't actually discharge anything. So we should be good and safe here in the garage. All right, one. All right, last one. Next up, Magpul. And I should mention that these are very easy to load up. Okay, so it did snap into place. Let's see how this puppy runs. Okay, there we had our first malfunction. Everything seemed to be running pretty smoothly. It seems like something might have broken in a little bit, and I'm seeing a little bit of wear on the inside of the feed lips. I'm wondering if this magazine is just pushed up a little bit too far, and the feed lips are making contact with the edges of the bolt. But you can see that third round did not want to present itself to the bolt face, and it didn't catch. So let's take another look. Yeah, it's just riding right over the, oh, okay. That one barely caught. Yeah, that's just riding right over the top. So something in there is kind of keeping the round pushed down a little bit too far. And it's not wanting to catch the back of the rim here. Let's see if we can figure out what that is. Okay, so that one catches just fine. I would like to know why it kind of hangs up at that point. All right, and I can see right here that the nose of this bullet is kind of diving down a little bit, but I do have lots of rim to catch. Yeah, and that's just pushing the nose of the bullet right down into the front of the magazine. So yeah, this is not working. I have to say, based on that and some of the other tests that I've done, that the Magpul one, not recommended for this chassis. Next up, Accurate Mag. I should mention that this one was the trickiest one to load, and actually all of these in a way are a little bit tricky. These are all designed for 308 or other short action cartridges like that, and the feed lips extend kind of far out. You can see that they're well past the shoulder. If we were actually shooting 308, that shoulder would be further forward, and we would have something to kind of press the rim up against when we're loading these mags up. So 6.5 Creedmoor with its shoulder set back quite a bit is it's a little bit trickier. Okay, that's a tight fit, which isn't necessarily bad. Okay, that was my fault. I caught it before the ejector could get it. Let's try this again. A little bit of a firmer hand. Oh, that actually felt really good. Oh, hold on. That one worked a lot better. It did require a firmer hand than with the MDT. This one is definitely smoother, but I think overall the whole rifle seems to require a bit of a firmer hand when feeding things, especially when compared to the Savage Model 10 GRS. But I don't see any wear marks on here, so I don't think it's actually catching on anything on the magazine. It might just be a little bit of difficulty getting out from under those feed lips. But yeah, these work. I would not recommend the Magpul P-Mag in this rifle if you're going to get one of these. Either of these should work, and I'm definitely going to tip things in favor of the MDT, which seems pretty obvious considering who made this thing. One thing that you have to keep in mind is that I'm at a really awkward angle trying to feed these in, so it looks really clunky. I'm not actually behind the rifle in a shooting position or anything, I'm kind of standing off to the side. So that's going to explain a little bit of the clunkiness getting things in there, and why I think that the Accurate Mag magazines should still work okay, even though it looks horrible from this angle. Now for some notes on the Accurate Mag bottom metal, if you're wanting to run one of these on your centerfire Savages. Of course, the Accurate Mag magazine should work just fine. That's what it was designed for. Everything fits really neatly, very tightly. That should work great. And I'm really looking forward to trying that out in the actual rifle. And of course, the Magpul P-Mag, as we discovered in the Model 10 GRS, should be a really slick feeder, and we'll see how it actually works with the 12FV. The one that is the standout is this one, the MDT. This actually doesn't fit in this mag well at all. This thing sticks in there really hard before it can even get to the point where the mag latch is. So I would not recommend picking up an MDT magazine if you want to be able to run it in your old model Savage 10 FCPSR or Model 10 GRS or whatever. I'd say stick to the other two. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So you can become a patron of the destructive arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.